This video is going to be based around the concept of making public records requests. Public records are any bureaucratic or governmental records, paperwork, documentation, what have you, that is then made available to the public upon request. And the different state public records acts are very similar to the Freedom of Information Act, which is a federal law. So for anyone that doesn't know, you are legally capable of obtaining this type of stuff, not just from your shelters, but from your government and any other bodies, to be able to hold these people accountable. And everybody needs to know about that ability that we all have, because we do have it. So there is a process to doing this, minimal paperwork, and most importantly, you need to be very specific with what you ask for. If you aren't specific, they'll likely play games with you and frustrate you in sort of like a game of hot potato, for lack of a better phrase. Many people will give up, and for those reasons of feeling like they aren't getting anywhere, or just the process alone is lost amongst our daily lives, because most of us are kind of busy, you know? So the other side, meaning in this case the shelter, can and probably will get tedious, and it may seem as though they want to fight you tooth and nail on every inch of handing over this information. But as long as you know what you're doing, and as long as you know your rights, they have to turn over this information. If they don't, you can sue them, and you will win. So just hang in there, and if they want to fight, fight back. I've recently put in requests for a handful of different things, the most recent being a 5-year record dump for overall outcomes at the Carson shelter specifically. That will be the subject matter of this video. What I did was I simply asked for total numbers of live intakes, total numbers of those adopted, those rescued, those returned to their owners, and then those euthanized. These numbers were to be given to me in that fashion over the last 5 years. So the document that I ended up getting back was one page. It had about 30 numbers on it, and they ended up charging me $48 for this single sheet of paper, because the LA Department of Animal Care and Control charge you $48 an hour in order to arrange what you eventually end up requesting. The funny part of all this is what I actually requested were numbers that they immediately already had on hand. The lady told me that right in the email that we were exchanging back and forth, yet they still charged me. Surprise. Is that legal? I have no idea, but I wasn't going to make a big deal out of it, because at the end of the day, all it was likely going to do was prolong the process of me actually getting my records, and that kind of works against me because that's probably what they wanted. So here I am with my $48 sheet of paper, and I'm sharing it with you guys. LA County doesn't do calendar years, so you will see that their years are broken down into fiscal years instead. What that represents is July 1st of one year through June 30th of the next. With the numbers they gave me, I then created a new document, and I think my document thoroughly breaks down the numbers in a handful of different ways. You can download my document right below this video. First thing I noticed, and hopefully the first thing you would notice, is if the intake total doesn't equal the other four totals, meaning adopted, rescued, returned, and killed combined, then that means that the shelter's lost or unaccounted for a specific number of animals. As you see on my document, hundreds of animals are going unaccounted for every single year. Now, are they being lost? Are they not being put into the system correctly? Are they going unaccounted for in the hopes that nobody knows or nobody sees it, and they're actually being killed in order to kind of fluff in their kill numbers or lighten their kill numbers? I don't know the answer. It could be any of those. It could be a combination of that. It could be none of those. I don't know. But the bottom line is they're not accounting for a specific number of animals. And as you can see, this latest fiscal year, which is not even over with, they are unaccounting for three times as many dogs, roughly, as they have been unaccounting for over the last 5 years. Second, I break down my PDF into raw numbers per year, outcome percentages per year, and then outcome numbers per day. My document first shows the total live impounds of both cats and dogs, then it shows just the dogs, and then it shows just the cats. Then at the very bottom, it combines all the numbers over the 5-year 2006 to 2011 fiscal years and breaks them down in the same manner, raw numbers, percentages, and then for both dogs and cats, then just dogs, and then just cats. The 5-year numbers do not include the current 2011-2012 fiscal year, just because I wanted it to be as accurate as possible. The years in green represent the tenure of current Carson shelter manager Gil Moreno. He took over during the back end of the 08-09 fiscal year. I greened out 2009 and beyond just to give him a fresh start. I'm still totally blown away by the amount of animals being misplaced or lost. Gil has lost 403 dogs this fiscal year alone, which still has 2 months left on it. By those numbers, the Carson shelter is losing or unaccounting for 1.4 dogs per day, 2.9 dogs and cats combined per day. That's ridiculous. They're continuing to kill roughly half of all dogs and cats that enter the shelter. Flip a coin, live or die. That's basically the reality at Carson. Unfortunately, these numbers don't even account for pit bull specific outcomes. I fear that their kill rates are close to 90%. These numbers are disgraceful. You cannot reform the people who are in these positions of power. The Carson shelter manager Gil Moreno, DACC general manager Marsha Maeda, these people need to go. They are apathetic, unimaginative, defensive, uncompassionate, vindictive. They are discriminatory towards specific types of dogs. They are death culture enforcers. You cannot reform these types of people. They need new jobs, and jobs that have nothing to do with animal welfare. That's it. Please spread this video. Thank you.